Howdy, y'all. It's Shannon from Creative Chaos in Tennessee. And I was able to join my very first YouTube hop for Through the Rainbow 2.0. Apparently some ladies did all the rainbow colors last year, and this year it's 2.0, so it's all the in-between colors. So for the month of May, the color was teal or turquoise. And so even though that is like my favorite color, I really struggled with this one to figure out what I wanted to do, what I wanted to use, what could really match up. I do love doing monochromatic layouts, but this one was a struggle because I feel like it wasn't really teal or turquoise, but it's close, and it's like all the shades. So it does have some of it in it. I'm going to use this picture, sorry if it has a glare, of me and my kitty cat Simba. This picture I actually took for a online crop. The challenge was to take a selfie laying on the floor, and as soon as I laid down, my cat ran over and laid down on my hair. So I thought that was hilarious. He just had to be a part of that selfie. And I am using, this is a close to my heart mix-ins paper I'm going to use for the background. And this paper is from the In Full Bloom scrapbook collection that I love so much. It's no longer available. It's my most favorite collection ever. This is a cut file that I can't say that I created it myself. I kind of did. I took several different files off of the Cricut Design Studio and combined them together to create this hexagon, the flower, the little bees. I added all of it around it and welded it, and then I cut it out, and I pretty much just backed it with some of the paper from the collection. There's an easy way to do it. You can just take and flip it over and put your paper under it and take a pencil and just trace around the outline and then cut it, and then voila, you have a paper that's backed. And I didn't do all of it. I wanted to kind of keep it neutral with the blues so that they really shined and the other colors didn't take over. And I just used up scraps because it's all I have left of this collection. I have enough to make probably a lot more layouts because I just have a lot of smaller scraps. And I have some of the Picture My Life cards left. I took and just fussy cut some of the flowers out of the paper, and they're not even full flowers, but I can tuck them in and use them. So pretty much what I wanted to do was just take and do some mixed media using this peacock feathers, and even though it's a brighter blue, I think that it will work. I hope it will work. I haven't tried it. But I did line this up, kind of. I played with it first to put it where I wanted it on the paper, and I did take a pencil and just put little marks around it so that I could kind of match up my mixed media. I did practice on the back of this real quick just to see if the colors would be okay since they were somewhat, and I think they look okay. So I'm just going to do the packaging technique, just take some packaging and add a little water to your ink and then put it on. And like I said, I have my little guidelines on there, so I kind of know where I want to put it, so that just a little bit of it will peek out and show. And I'm so excited to be joining this hop, y'all. Like, go and check out all the other ladies. that are participating also. I think that's good. I do want to add a little bit of white dot on, or white splatters rather. I'm gonna wipe that off, or I'll have it on everything else. And this is just Dina Wakely Media Gloss Spray. If I can get the lid off. Every single time I use this and pull the lid off, it's like it gets stuck. Okay, or maybe we're not going to do this because I'm going to have to get my husband to open the bottle. Okay, we're just going to spray a little bit maybe. See if I can get some little droplets to come out. I don't like that it's not like little spots. And I think I may even roll my paper towels over it just so that it dries fast. Because I just don't have all day to be waiting on spray to dry. I'm very impatient when it comes to creating. Okay, so I like this pretty good. Hopefully everything's in frame, and let me stand up and check. Okay, yeah, we're pretty good. Okay, so with this, I think that I have my little guide marks of where I wanted it to line up at. And you can always make sure you do them in pencil if you do that, so that you can go back and fix that. Erase them. I'll think of it in a minute what I'm trying to say. It's been a very long day. I have managed to watch all three of my grandbabies today. I watched the youngest one this morning, and then I watched the older two tonight. And I'm just putting some foam tape on the back of this so that it'll give it a little bit of something extra. Pull these off. Thank you guys for the suggestions that y'all have been sending of things that I could do and things y'all would like to see. I am working on getting my ideas down and working on a few different projects so that I can show y'all those in the future, hopefully very soon. This up with my guide marks. Okay, and I think for my picture, I think I just want to put it inside of here. This worked out a lot better when tape was not involved. Whenever I was planning. Okay. I think I'm just going to dab a little bit of liquid glue behind it to hold it down instead of trying to pull it back out and tape it. After I add all the other stuff, it is going to be fine either way. I'm still working with some of these glossy pictures. I love the matte ones, but for some reason, I ended up getting them glossy. Positive that I probably just did not select the map button when I ordered my pictures. I kind of wanted to put this in down here. I did rough up the edges of my paper with this little distress tool. I've had it for a gazillion years. I think I'll just go with that. I'm gonna put it in. And I'm just gonna, this is just a piece of zip strip that I wanted to use up. And then I have one that I cut for up here on this edge. Glue this down. Well, let me pull my tape up a little bit so I can get it in there. I have this piece of zip strip. This is all from the same collection. It's not very often that I actually scrapbook from all the same collection because I love to mix and match my stuff. I got glue all over my fingers, sorry. Alright, I think I want to put this here, but I think I want to pop it up on some foam tape. I ran the other roll out just now, so let me get this one. I do like that. Okay, let's see, what else? I have all these pieces. Kind of want to fill in this little hole so you're not seeing like where the picture ends. Are not fully cut, so I think I'm just gonna try to kind of tuck them in somewhere here. I think I like that. I might put a little piece of foam tape underneath both of those just to give them a little razzle dazzle. Alright, there's that one. I like that. I already put some foam tape on this one. I think I want it here just to help build the cluster, kind of. Yeah, let's do that. Move it up so it's kind of in the corner of the hexagon. Okay, and then I have these butterflies. From that stamp set, from the In Full Bloom, and kind of just want to add those like that. Normally I work in groups of three, but I'm kind of liking that. Normally, I would put the bigger butterfly at the bottom because it's heavier, and then the little one, but I lock them like that. Okay, so then I have some other leftover stickers from the collection, and come up. Got some more flowers I can add in. A little more. Do I want to add in the green? I mean, I do have a little bit of green in the papers, but I want to keep the focus, the blues, the teals, and the turquoise. And, let's do that. Put a little piece of foam tape behind that. Just to give it a little bit of something extra. There. I don't want to cover up too much of my bee. Normally I would have backed its little wings and did this in yellow, but I wanted to keep the color palette neutral. I do have this these little blings that I thought I could add to some of the flowers. I need my smaller one, but I don't know where it's at the moment. My table is a mess. I'm a messy crafter, and I've got a lot of irons in the fire at the moment. Oh, wait, I think I found them. Okay. Well, I found that empty package. Okay, this one will match. It's got some of the same colors. It's got that little goldish color. I think I'll just add these to the flowers. Centers. I really love my bling. If y'all haven't figured that out yet, I'm gonna put this on the bigger one. Let's see. To use up these labels. It's so hard for me to use labels. Like, I don't know why. It's just hard. I don't know. Do I want to add another butterfly to this corner down here? Let's see. I do kind of like it. And it would do my rule of three. Okay. I'm going to do it. Y'all talked me into it. If you don't like it, don't tell me. Just kidding. I do like constructive criticism. Let's see. And I do have a thing that makes it unsticky, but since I put a little bit of foam tape, I think it'll be fine. I do have a close to my heart clear shimmer brush, so I think I will add a little sparkle with that to my butterflies. Just to give them that shimmer. This is my favorite one, the clear one, because you can put it on everything. Like everything, everything. Okay. I like my sparkle. Okay. Okay, y'all. I think that's the layout. I will add some close-ups at the end. And you guys be sure to go and check out all the other ladies that's participating in Through the Rainbow. And until next time, see y'all later. Bye.